हम देख रहे हैं 11th स्टैंडर्ड मैथमेटिक्स का इंसर्ट इमेज से चैप्टर नंबर फर्स्ट, जिसका एक्सरसाइज है 1.3। हम आज देखेंगे 1.3 में से एग्जांपल नंबर 3 का 1x1 सॉल्यूशन। इसके लिए मैं सतीश आपका स्वागत करता हूँ एसयू लर्निंग में। आज हम देखने वाले हैं एग्जांपल नंबर 3 ऑफ एक्सरसाइज 3। ओके, तो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द एग्जांपल नंबर 3। व्हाट एग्जांपल नंबर 3 एग्जैक्टली सेज, लेट ए इक्वल्स टू 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 इज ऑफ Which of the following statements are incorrect and why? Which of the following statements are incorrect and why? Means you need to check which is incorrect and which is not correct. If it is not correct, you need to give some reason for that incorrectness. Okay. Here are some examples of subset: belongs to, does not belongs to. Therefore, we will see the quickly the definition of belongs to subset and set A. Now, suppose you are having some set A. What is meant by set? Set A is nothing but collection of well-defined objects of some kind. Okay, that is nothing but your set definition. Now, what about set A and B, the belongs to relation? Now, suppose you are having some set A and you need to check whether some elements belonging to it or not. Then the definition says, suppose A is a set and element small a is belonging to A, if and only if that element A lies in that set A, then we will write A belongs to A, small a belongs to A. This is for elements and the set belongs to. Now the next set, what is subset means by? Subset, for subset you will require two or more than two sets. Suppose A and B are any two sets, you will say A is subset of B if and only if all elements of A are elements also in B. Means what? Now we will use the definition of belongs to here. Means for all elements of A belongs to A, we must have that A in B. We will not check elements of B, but we will check all elements of A that are belonging to it. We will check whether they are in B or not. Then only we can say A is subset of B. If it is not so, then A will not be subset of B. Means while checking the subset, we will check the elements of that set. And while checking the belongs to ness, we will check the element itself, whether it is belonging to that set or not. It means your belongs to is related to elements and subset is related to set only. Okay. Now we will just go on example number 3. Example number 3 ka set maine yahan pe likh ke liya hai, jisme se aapko first example yahan pe milega, which is nothing but set 3, 4 subset of A. Need to check the your symbols. 3, 4 is subset of A or not. For definition of subset, I have told you, suppose I will denote it first set as A1 is nothing but 3, 4. Now check whether elements of A, all elements of A are in A1 are in A or not. I will check one by one. Now suppose 2 belongs to A1, but whether my 2 belongs to, sorry, 2 is not in A1. Why I am taking 2? I will not take 2, I will take 3. Since 3 is in A1. Now whether my 3 belongs to A or not, that I will check. Okay. Now look at here. I will have 1, 2, 3, 4. This is one element. 5. Nowhere I am having element 3 in set A. Therefore, I am having element 3 in A1, which is not in A. What this indicates? Your A1 is not subset of A. Okay. Definitely here A1 can be belongs to A, since my A1 element A1 is in A. Therefore, I can say A1 belongs to A, but I cannot say A1 is subset of A. For this, your definition does not allow you to say so. Why so? Since all elements of A1 are not in in A. Therefore, you will not say A1 is subset of A. Clearly look at here. You need to check the elements when going to subset, and you need to check element of that itself, the set itself as an element, to check whether it is belonging to or not. Okay, while checking belonging to, we will consider that set as an element, and while checking the subset, we will take the elements of that set. Okay, therefore the first is a wrong statement, which is not correct, since all elements of this set are not in A. Therefore this will not become a subset. Okay. Since this was example number first, now we will move on to example number 2. 3, 4 belongs to A. I guess the answer of second question we have discussed here only. Okay, whether my 3, 4 belongs to A or not, Whenever I will check belongs to 3 comma 4, I will consider this as one element. Okay, this is one element. Now whether 3 comma 4 belongs to A or not, definitely sure 3 comma 4 is in A, therefore I will call 3 comma 4 belongs to A, since this element is in A. Okay, that set is, I am considering it as element, therefore this can be true, means checked is true. Now next, what about the set 3, 4, singleton set 3, 4. Okay, this is your set and that is having singleton element 3, 4. Okay, now 3, 4 is an element of set this A2, I will call it as A2. It means what? Your 3, 4 belongs to A. Look at here carefully. 3, 4 is the elements of A2. It is an element, it is not subset. Okay, 3, 4 belongs to A, but A2, but 3, 4 also belongs to A. Okay, means what? The element, all elements of A2. What elements of A2 are nothing but singleton 3, 4. This is your set and which has singleton element 3, 4, which also belongs to A. Therefore, I will definitely say A2 is subset of A. Okay, why this is so? Since A2 ke jo bhi elements hai, abhi main A2 ke elements kaun se le raha hu? Single 3, 4. 3, 4 jo bhi aayega, wo aapka wo element rahega जो आपके A2 में होगा, और वही एलिमेंट आपको A में भी मिल रहा है, तो ऑल एलिमेंट्स ऑफ A2 व्हिच इज नथिंग बट 3, 4 आल्सो इन A, देयरफॉर आई विल से A2 इज सबसेट ऑफ A. हियर आई विल चेक द ऑल एलिमेंट्स ऑफ A2 दैट आर नथिंग बट 3, 4 ओनली, बट दिस इज इन A, देयरफॉर योर नेक्स्ट सेट A2 हैज बिकम सबसेट ऑफ A. ओके, नाउ द नेक्स्ट फोर्थ वन, वन बिलोंग्स टू A और नॉट, श्योरली योर वन इज इन A, सेट A is lying in set A, therefore I will say 1 belongs to A. Now whether my 1 subset of A or not, okay, whether my 1 is subset of A, 1 subset of A. Now check whether 1 is subset of A or not. Now if 1, but 1 is definitely here, you can see 1 is element of A, 1 is element of A, definitely surely, means if 1 is lying in A. Now we need to check whether 1 is a subset of A or not. Okay, for this we will be check, we need to take all elements of 1, all elements of 1, whether they are in A or not. But before that we must take whether 1 is a set or not. Here 1 is not set, therefore we cannot have the subset definition for your A. Therefore you cannot check the elements of 1. Okay, to check the subset, we need to check that whether it is the elements of that set, of all elements of that set are in A or not. Your elements of A, 1, are not in A. Here we cannot check any elements of A. Therefore, we will say A is not subset of A. You can definitely say 1 is a, 1 belongs to A here. But your 1 is not subset of A. Actually, any element of set A is not subset of itself. Okay, just note it down. Any element, you can write it down, any element of set is not subset, cannot be subset of itself. Okay, means if you are taking any element from that set, suppose I will give you some example here. Suppose 1 is there, 2, 3, 4 and so on, and I want to check whether element 1 is subset of set A, set A or not. Okay, whether it is subset, I will need to write subset. My 1 is subset of A or not, that for this we will check elements of 1, elements of singleton 1. That are nothing but 1, which is belongs to 1. But whether this 1 belongs to your set A or not, that I will check. That 1 will not belong to set A. Therefore, I will not call this singleton A as subset of that set, since this will not contain all elements of set 1 in A. Therefore, we will not set this one as subset. Definitely, you can say 1
belongs to A or not. Then you will check the element singleton 1 is lying in A or not. The element singleton 1 is in A, therefore you will say singleton 1 is belonging to 1. But singleton 1 will never become a subset of 1. Okay? See, singleton 1 is here, element. But singleton 1, what about singleton 1 of any in general set A if A is an element? Okay? If A is an element, that term you can say this is a subset. Means you need to check two definitions here. You need to check whether it is an element of A or not. Suppose I have explained you before. Now suppose A is nothing but your A1, A2 and so on. If you are checking the element singleton A1, okay, whether it is subset of A or not, okay, that you need to check. Now surely this will become a subset of A. Why this is so? Since my elements of A, singleton A, A1 is in A, therefore it will become subset. But what about singleton A belonging to A or not? Here, if you are writing belonging to that, you need to check that your element is not. Here, singleton A1 is not there, therefore you will not say it is belonging to. Therefore, while checking the belonging to, you need to check the element, and while checking the subset, you need to check element of that set. Okay, therefore any element of set will never become a subset of that set itself. Therefore, your question number, example number 5 is incorrect. Next, example number 6 says 1, 2, 3 subset of A or not. Okay, here 1, 2 and 3 subset of A. Okay, is 1, 2 and 5, sorry. My mistake here. 1, 2 and 5, you can see on your screen. 1, 2 and 5 subset of A or not. That I will just take 1, 2 and 5 as A. I will check all elements of A are in A or not. For this, we will check the one by one elements of X. Now, 1 is in X, but 1 is also in A. Okay? 2 is in X, 2 is in B, also A. My 5 is in X, that 5 also belongs to your A. Means for all elements, all X, small X belonging to X, this implies that X is in your set A. Okay? That X is in set A. This is the simple definition of subset. Therefore, you will have X subset of A, surely. For all elements of A, you will have elements in A. Okay? Now, the next example number 7. What it says? 1, 2, 5, whether it belongs to A or not. Okay? The same situation you can see here. 1, 2, 5, with 1, 2, 5. Now, what 1, 2 and 5 belongs to A implies is nothing but the element 1, 2, 5 is in A. Now check whether the element 1, 2, 5 is in A or not. You cannot see any element like 1, 2, 5 in set A. Therefore, you will have this statement wrong. This is a wrong statement. Since you will not have any element 1, 2, 5 in set A, therefore you cannot write A, 1, 2, 5 belongs to A. Okay? Therefore, A, 1, 2, 5, single set 1, 2, 5 will not belong to A. Absolutely, it will be subset that we have seen example number 6. But it will not belong to your set. Now example number 8. What example number 8 says? Set 1, 2, 3. Now I will change my set 1, 2, 3. Look at here, what is happening. That we need to check it as subset or not. Okay? You need to check subset. For subset, what you will check? The elements of that set. All elements. I have told you, for subset, you need to check all elements. Now, 1 is in this set, but 1 is also in A. Also, 2 is in this set, but 2 is in here. But check whether what happens with element 3 of this set. The element 3 of this set is not in A. Okay? There it means the element, I need to rub this. Okay, the element 3 which it belongs to this set. Okay? 3 is belongs to 1, 2, 3, but 3 does not belong to A. What this implies? Your 1, 2, 3 cannot be subset of A. If there exists any element which is in set A and that element must not be in B, that time A will not be in subset of B. This is the definition of subset. Therefore, you cannot write 1, 2, 3 as a subset of A. Okay, this is a wrong statement. Now the next example is the example number 9. What example 9? Example number 9 says is the symbol 5 belongs to A. Okay, now we will check whether 5 belongs to A or not. What phi is nothing but? Phi is nothing but the empty set. Mind it, empty set. It is not an singleton element. That's okay. I know sets can be elements. Obviously, you know the set elements of power set. That are nothing but sets only. Sets can be element. But check whether that phi belongs to here or not. Phi is belong to A or not. Okay. Here they have given it as phi belongs to A. You need to check elements belongs to A or not. For this, you will require the element phi in A. Now element, since it is belongs to, it means element phi is in A. Okay, but check whether your phi is in A or not. You will have no phi in your set A. If here you are having phi in A, what do you mean by phi is in A? It is nothing but like this. If you are having phi, comma, like this. If this is the case, then you can say phi belongs to A. But this is not case here. Therefore, you will write phi does not belong to A. The element phi does not belong to A. Therefore, you will write phi does not belong to A. Therefore, your example number 9 is also incorrect. Now example number 10, phi subset of A. What example number 10 says? Okay, what example number 10 says? Subset means what? You need to check whether the elements of phi are in A or not. While checking the subset, you need to check the elements of that set, not that set. The elements of that set is in A or not. Now elements of phi is nothing but the empty set which has no elements. Therefore, no need of going to check the elements. Practically, the A phi will become subset of A. By the way, the empty set is subset of any set. Okay? Empty set is a subset of any set. Therefore, this is universally true. You will have phi subset of A. Means for any set A, you will have phi as a subset of that set A. Since there are no elements, therefore you will not check elements. You can avoid the definition. There will not any element in phi which is not in B, A. Therefore, you cannot say phi is not subset of A. You cannot prove. Therefore, phi is also subset of A. And last but not the least, 11th number, singleton phi. Singleton phi is a subset of A or not. Okay? For this, you need to check the element phi. Okay? The element phi, is it A or not? Now, check. Here, this is the set. And the phi is nothing but your element. Okay? Phi is your element. Again, whether your phi, element phi, if this is the case, then you need to check the element phi belonging to singleton set phi is in A or not. Okay, is in A or not. But you can see the element phi which is belonging to this set is which is nowhere in set A. Therefore, you are having the element phi which is in this set but which is not in A. Therefore, you will have singleton phi not subset of A, since phi does not belong to A. Phi is subset of A, definitely, but phi does not belong to A. Therefore, you will have the singleton phi set not subset of A. This was all about your belongs to names and subset of your set property. If you are having any problem regarding the definition of belongs to and subset, please write us in our comment section. And if you are having any query related to these answers, just write also in our comment section. Don't forget to like, comment and subscribe this channel. Thank you.